Welcome back, guys. Tactical AV here.
You know, since there's so many different things that I need to get off my mind, well, I thought it'd be a good idea just to make an update video to let you guys know exactly what I've been doing and what's been going on with some of the things that I've been using.
First of all, I can tell you that I'm definitely done with my review of the Red Dragon Audio S500 stereo power amplifiers so far.
And on the other spectrum of things, well, it was the Klipsch bookshelf speakers on the budget end of things that I was kind of reviewing over the last several weeks here.
And unfortunately, yes, it is true. I blew up my Marantz amplifier.
The dreaded power light flashing 2 times a second in protection mode.
And no, unfortunately, factory resetting it doesn't get this out of protection mode just yet.
But when something like this does happen to you guys, I'm hoping that the first thing you'll do is definitely unplug the power cord.
And a lot of times it's simply a thermal issue that causes the device to go into an overprotection mode.
Most of the time, simply ventilating the unit properly won't mean that it will not overheat technically, but you do want to give it proper ventilation at least, even if it is out in the open.
If it's in something like a closed cabinet, well then you absolutely imperative and need cooling or fans.
You see, for the Marantz and Denon owners, fortunately there's a way to factory reset your AV processor, preamp, or receiver. And particularly on this unit, it happens to be the Game Odyssey DSX button pressed in conjunction with the power button and will factory reboot the device.
But believe it or not, I've actually had this happen to me before on other amplifiers in the past.
Most of the times, just installing an external fan on a device or unit like such is usually the key to making it last for another 10 to 15 years at least.
Not in this case, though. Nope. Factory resetting it does not take this unit out of protection mode yet.
Although, fortunately, my unit does happen to be under warranty still, which means I won't necessarily be able to take it apart and let you guys know exactly what went wrong with it.
To be honest with you, I wouldn't even do it if I had the opportunity to do so.
In fact, several years ago, I had a similar unit, or at least in cost, fail in a similar way where it happened to actually be the smoothing capacitors. And, well, in that situation, it took an oscilloscope or O-scope to bring the line voltage up slowly and wait until we have proper power to all devices.
And obviously be replacing the capacitors. But in this instance, I can let you know a little bit about what happened, and it gives me an exact idea of what exactly went wrong with this.
You see, I've often stressed about the use of external power amplifiers. In fact, I've tried to emphasize that most of my videos, that using the external power amplifiers for, well, music and movie playback is often the key to not only prolonging the lifespan of your unit, but also obtaining a higher quality and fidelity of audio than the onboard Class D amplifiers most surround sound receivers are going to come with onboard.
And it just happens to be quite interesting, since when I was debuting my brand new, very, very budget Klipsch speakers, I happened to take my Marantz unit off of the external power amplifier simply for a short period of time while I connected the speakers directly to my Marantz. After a playback of about a half an hour at about 70% volume on my Marantz, I was simply amazed at the quality and amount of power and, well, fidelity that both systems were capable of producing. It wasn't until shortly thereafter that the amplifier was sitting idling with no audio emitting from the speakers when I heard a pop, specifically in my Klipsch speakers. In fact, the pop was so loud that everyone in the house kind of looked up and went, "What was that?" And fortunately, no, there wasn't any smoke coming from the top of my receiver, which definitely tells me that this wasn't a thermal-related failure.
You see, electronics failures come in all shapes and sizes. And well, in this instance, our situation, I can tell you that it's definitely the onboard amplifier modules that might have blown inside of this.
Alright, so the trick then is to see if your unit is still obviously covered under warranty. Despite the very fact that I'm extremely surprised this happened and will definitively find out exactly what went wrong with my unit and determine if there's anything I can do in the future to avoid this issue happening,
I'm gonna think that there are some things I can do.
And well, you can do exactly the same thing.
But in my situation, since the unit happens to be under warranty still, it gives me a few different options. and after reaching out to Marantz, I've located certain service shops that are licensed and authorized by Marantz to repair their equipment. And, as always, two things are likely to happen. A, the repair goes not as planned and they don't have the parts or determine that it's too expensive to fix a model that may be out of date. In that situation, most likely, you're offered a, well, refurbished model of the same unit or similar unit with similar cost. In fact, in most cases, people are offered refurbished units if their unit is deemed unrepairable. Or, well, 86. And option B is simply, you have someone fix it, they're capable of fixing it, have parts available, fix it, you're on your way, and everything is up and working again. When things are working, you're just that much happier. But for now, I've got a few different things to focus on that I'm simply going to have to separate the videos. And of course, don't forget to check out my full review of the Red Dragon Audio S500 Stereo Power Amplifiers. I'll have a different video on the Klipsch Bookshelf speakers, so don't worry about those. But Santa's got a few more goodies before we move on quite yet. So make sure to check out the next video, guys. I'll of course be following closely what happens to the one main Marantz model that I've been using. In fact, now this gives me the opportunity to shop around for the preamp processor from Marantz I've always desired. And I've also got a few new toys I think some people are gonna like. So don't forget to subscribe, guys. Hit the thumbs up if you liked this video. And I'll be back with a ton more.